Assalamu alaikum and welcome again. Now we will talk about system life cycle, the stage design. It is part two. We will talk in it about verification and validation. You will find it in your book at page 137. Now, verification. Verification is the way of preventing errors when data is copied from one medium to another, like from paper to disk or to your monitor. There are two common ways that verification checks are carried out. The first one is double entry. The second one is the visual check. When I talk about double entry, I talk about the method which is the data is entered twice using two people and then it is compared together. Now, either after data entry or during the data entry process. So I will enter some data and my colleague will enter the data again. Now we will compare our data together to find out that data is entered in the correct way. Also, there is another example like here. Like now, if I want to assign a new password, I have to enter the current password. Then I have to write a new password. Then I have to retype the new password to find out that I have entered the new password in the correct way. If I enter it in another way, like it is wrong. Now I want to change, passwords do not match. So by this is the verification for my new password. I entered the new password twice. The confirmation was not matching the new password, so the system will not take this data. By verification, it is refused. But visual check is checking for errors by person who is entering the data. They compare the entered data with the original document. How? By comparing the original paper document with your computer or screen. Now, note that this is not the same as proofreading. So, the visual check is not proofreading. We will talk about proofreading later. After this, we will talk about validation. So, verification is done. It is done by us as people. Now, validation is done by the system, by the computer, to check also the data it is entered in the correct way. Now, validation is the process where data is checked to see if it satisfies certain criteria when input to the computer. Now, for example, to see if the data falls within accepted boundaries or frame, a number of validation techniques here in this table. You will find it now, the name of the check, the description with some examples. Now, let's see some of the validation checks which is carried out by a computer software. Now, we have the range check. Range check is to check whether the data is within the given acceptable values. Like what? To check if the person age is greater than 0, but it is also less than 150. Also, for the range check, if I want to check the score or the mark for the student for the first month exam, I will find that the maximum mark is 20 and the minimum is 0. So the student mark should be within the range of 0 to 20. I cannot exceed 20 and also it will not be less than 0. So it will use the range check. The lookup check. This checks whether the data entered exists in stored is stored in the table of data. Like what? Check is senior manager exists as an option in the query such as please enter your job title. So when I want to enter the job title and I have entered senior manager, now if I don't have the lookup check and this company has no job description or job title as senior manager, we will have a problem because I have entered some job title which is not existing in this company. So this company should afford or provide the form of registration by what? By lookup check that will find the job titles are existing or not in this one. If I want to give another example, like cities in Jordan, I can find out if Amman is in the checklist or it is in my lookup check. Maybe someone entered a city which is not a main city as a city in Jordan. So the lookup check will find that it is not existing. So it will restrict that nobody can put some city which is not available, like Jeddah. Jeddah is not in Jordan. It is in Saudi Arabia. So the checkup here will do it, the lookup check. Now, length check. It checks if the input data contains required number of characters. Like what? When I say that the plate number of the car is just only 4 digits. If I enter 5 digits number, it will not be accepted because I have added one extra digit. So it is wrong. Okay? Same here. If a field needs 6 digits, then inputting a 5-digit or 7-digit number, for example, should cause an error message. Also, our mobile numbers. When I say to have a mobile number, I should put 07, then the key of the company, followed by 7 numbers. So all of this is 9 digits. If somebody is giving you their mobile number in 8 digits or 10 digits, you will recognize that this is a wrong number. You will ask them to add or to remove the extra digit. So the length digit here is just to find out how many characters or digits I should have in my data. Now the character or type check. It checks that the input data does not contain invalid characters. If I want to enter the age or the weight of some people or a person, I cannot put letters in this field because it should only have some numbers. Also, person's name should not contain any numbers, but a person's height should only contain digits. By this, we can check that it is character or type check. After this, we have the format or picture check. Like what? It checks that the data in a specific format. The best example here is to talk about the date. The date format in the UK system is DDMM 4Ys. So I can put this date in this format, but if it is US, it will be MMDD4Y. Now, if I want to enter some date like it is 15th of January, I put 1501 and the year number. But if it is in US, I cannot put the 15 in the first. It will be 0115. There is no 15 in the months. The maximum number for months is 12. So it will cause some error. Because of this, to avoid this error, I should announce for the user the format or the picture check for this date, just to let them put it in the correct way. Now the presence check. It's checking if data actually present and hasn't been missed out. If I want to enter some data in a new form to submit in a new forum or in a new group, I should fill some fields. The fields with the star, the red star, it means it is a must fill in field. If I forgot to enter this field, the presence check will make some error message that there is some important fields are not filled, they are empty. So like this, it is an like an example, electronic form, person's telephone number may be required field. So if no data entered in this telephone number, this should give rise an error message. Okay, now the consistency check. It is checking if the field correspond or tie up with each other. Like, if you have the Mr. here as a title, so it should be the gender male. And if it is Mrs. or Miss, so the gender will be female. The data should be consistent. This is the consistency check. Now the check digit. Check digit, you can find it in your box, in any item that you buy from the store. Why? Because it is the extra digit added to a number which is calculated from the digits, which is now you will find it in sections 612 and 613 when we talk about the online shopping and so on. But we will now see some photo to tell about the check digit. Now let's see the example of the book. It's talking about the check digit can identify three types of error. If two digits have been transported during the input, like 13597 instead of 13579, so I have some data which is transferred with error, or incorrect digit entered twice, like 13559 instead of 13579, so I have some mistyping, or I have a digit missed out altogether, like I have entered 1359 instead of 13. I have missed here the 7. So all of this is like mistyping, or if it is like we are using barcode reader, we have some error in the barcode reader. So here we have some example of check digit. Now this is a barcode which is for any item or stock. Now this barcode will be read by the system, even by using some barcode reader, or the user will enter this number using some numeric keypad. After entering the number, this 8 will be checked against some calculations will be done on these numbers. Now the result of the calculation should match the 8. If the match is done, so this barcode is valid and everything will be okay. If not, some error message will be raised on your system that telling you the barcode read is not okay. Now, after we did the validation and verification, now we have to make the design of the file structure. Now, to design the file structure, it means to design and to agree on the file that we will work on in this database. By this, we are talking about the file names. Each file has field names, with each for them has field length, field type, and suitable validation check. This is called data dictionary. So, when I want to talk about it, the field used in the files taking into account field length, field name, and field data type. Data dictionary is used to show suitable field names, as an example here. So if any time you are asked to make or to design some data dictionary for any database, even it is in practical or theory, this means you have to give each table a name to find what are the suitable field names, each one of them, what's the data type, what is the suitable validation check, if possible. Yani, like product name here, it has none. There is no suitable validation, but for the product code, here the length check. For the year, it will be range check. For the location of the stock, it will be character check. It should be numeric. And for the color, it will be alphanumeric, so it will be lookup check because we cannot add any color which is out of the list. Now, after file structure, design and testing the testing strategy plan, when producing the software for the new system, it is very important to test it is thoroughly in order to. Why it is important? To make sure it meets the agreed client requirements. All of your work is to match the client requirement. So you have to make them satisfied that you are serving all of their requirements. Also, remove any bugs or errors from the system. Also, make sure it produces the required output for data when the correct output is already known. Now, check that software does not crash under certain conditions. Now, when I want to work on design and test the strategy plan, I have to make sure that these 4 points are clear to us why to do it. Now, to do this, it is necessary to produce testing strategy or plan to ensure that all possible scenarios have been tested so that the criteria have been met. Refer to section 3.2 for more information. It will be for the next lesson, inshallah. Okay, so by this, we have finished the design stage. Now, after this, it is just only to find out a summary for the lesson. If you want, it will be in your booklet. You can find it in the booklet and also you can read it here. I will not read for you, but you can make pause and find your notes. Also, it is in your summary booklet, which is distributed in the first days of this semester. So this is the design and this is the summary for verification as double entry and visual check. Here are the validations. As you see, you can pause and find out whatever you want in the summary. And good luck.